Before you get out your pitchforks, let me say that I enjoy playing Genshin Impact. The game is beautiful to look at, and a lot of love and care has clearly been put into all of the characters. And to be honest, I am something of a sucker for a good waifu gacha collector. However, the more I play Genshin, the more I realize that the game suffers from an extreme identity crisis, where it can't figure out what it wants to be. The game is simultaneously trying to be an open-world adventure game, a mobile-style gacha waifu collector, and an MMORPG. This lack of clarity of what the game wants to be has kneecapped the game's enjoyability, especially in the late game after around AR50. It is increasingly clear that miHoYo needs to make substantial changes to their game if they want to keep players around in the long term, but their design choices have backed themselves into a corner where they do not have the ability to do so. I started playing Genshin Impact in February of this year after being initially hesitant to pick it up because of the game's poor gacha rates. For context, I'm someone who primarily played Azure Lane, so I've gotten used to getting every single limited banner character with relative ease without paying. But after a bit of nudging from my friends, I finally decided to pick the game up and give it a try. My first 30-ish hours of the game were fantastic. Genshin is really at its best when you're exploring the world and progressing through the story. It felt like there was something new to explore, some new secret to find, hidden behind every corner of the map. While there is some gating of the story based on your adventure rank, there's enough to explore in the beginning that it doesn't feel like that much of a barrier. The beginning of Genshin really feels like Breath of the Wild for weebs, which is something I can really get behind. But at a certain point, the game starts to slow down. You start to run out of main story quests to do. There are some character side stories to do and the occasional event every once in a while, but once you hit AR45, you're greeted with the game's primary endgame activity, running artifact domains over and over again to try and find the right artifacts for your characters. This is the point where the game transitions from being a story-driven open-world adventure game into being more of a traditional MMO. By the time your AR ticks up to AR50, you have basically exhausted everything there is to do in the world. Aside from events, your only real activity is farming for artifacts and materials for leveling up characters. However, because you have to get all sorts of materials with a limited resin system, like talent level up books, world boss drops, ascension materials, EXP books, etc., you still have a lot of things to do, even if the primary exploration and story part of the game is over. Once you reach a point where you have all of the characters you want built to your satisfaction, there is basically nothing to do anymore. You log in every day to do your daily commissions and burn some resin, and then you log out after 30 minutes tops. This is the crux of the problem of Genshin Impact. The endgame is incredibly boring. I've only been playing this game since February, and I have already exhausted all the game's exploration and story content. I still have some characters to build, my team is far from optimized, but I find myself increasingly disillusioned with the game. What's the point of doing a bunch of repetitive domains just to get some HP artifacts? The game's primary endgame challenge is the Spiral Abyss, which itself isn't even that hard. Unless you're the type of person who really wants to min-max all of your character builds for fun, once you build a team that is capable of consistently 3-starring floor 12, there is genuinely nothing else to do besides log in, do your daily commissions, spend your resin and log out, all taking 30 minutes generously. This is not a new complaint. People have been complaining about Genshin's endgame dearth of content since the beginning. miHoYo clearly must be aware that this problem exists for their endgame players, a group who inevitably gets larger and larger with every passing day. You can find no shortage of people on Reddit, YouTube, or other online forums giving their solutions on how to make endgame more interesting. But yet, miHoYo seems content to just create totally random event minigames, like what they did during the Windbloom Festival or the Lantern Festival, with the occasional world boss thrown in, rather than trying to seriously retool the game's endgame in order to create content that is more interesting and challenging. However, this is where you get to the crux of the problem of Genshin's design. Its attempts to be equal part action combat, open world adventure game, MMO style loot grinder, and anime gacha character collector all come into conflict and prevent the creation of a game that excels in any of these categories. This can be most vividly seen in the game's boring endgame, where I would argue that the problem is not that miHoYo doesn't want to create challenging endgame content, but the monetization system and game design choices they've made actively prevent them from creating substantively difficult and challenging endgame content. So what do I mean by that? Central to the problem here is the extreme degree of randomness that is baked into almost every level of this game. I don't just mean the gacha system, which itself I find rather offensive. In what universe is it acceptable for it to potentially cost over $400 to roll an event 5-star? Rather, it's a combination of this and the other random BS that goes into building a character, which is really the primary content available to you in this game. Not only do you have to randomly roll the character and weapons off the gacha, building out your characters also comes with a host of other completely unnecessary randomness built in. To level up their talents past level 6, you need to collect materials that drop randomly from bosses you can only fight once per week. If you are paying for weapons off the Battle Pass, Gacha, or Star Glitter Shop, your best option is to forge weapons at the Blacksmith, which also requires random drops of prototype blueprints that also only drop from the weekly bosses at an absolutely abysmal rate. But then you have the Artifact system, which, oh boy, is by and away one of the worst equipment systems I have ever seen in any game. In order to get artifacts, you need to farm various domains, which are basically rooms where you fight a couple of random monsters. Each domain has two primary sets of artifacts that it drops, and you're only guaranteed to get 2 5-star artifacts per run. So right off the bat, you only have a 50% chance to get the specific artifact set that you want. However, artifacts are further divided into 5 different types: flowers, plumes, goblets, sands, and circlets. Each artifact also comes with its own set of main stats and substats. The flowers and plumes are each guaranteed to have HP and attack as their main stats respectively. Sands have one of 5 randomly generated stat categories, circlets have one of 7. But where this gets really egregious is with the goblets, which not only can have one of the primary stat types like HP percent, attack percent, or defense percent, they can also be percent increase for each type of elemental damage, including physical. This means that there are 11 possible main stats for your goblets. This wouldn't be so bad if it wasn't also for the second part of artifacts, the substats. Each 5-star artifact can randomly have either 3 or 4 substats on it when you acquire it. Basically, the most important stat to roll in your artifacts is crit damage and crit percentage, as well as energy recharge on some support characters. Not only is it random what substat you get on your artifacts, every time you level up your artifact by 4 levels, it randomly increases one of its substats. This means you can roll a very good artifact with both crit damage and crit percentage on it and have it completely ruined after you've invested thousands of mora and artifact XP into it because you wasted all of the level up rolls on flat defense or something. In conclusion, in order to get good artifacts, you need to first randomly roll the correct artifact set out of 2 possible. Then you need to hope you get the right type of artifact with the right main stats and preferably 4 substats rolls, with 2 of them being crit damage and crit percentage. Even then, you just need to pray to the Archons that the right substats get boosted as you level up your artifacts. In practice, what this means is that there is an abysmally low Powerball lottery-esque percentage chance of getting good artifacts for your characters. Not to mention that you need to get a full set of 5 artifacts for 8 different characters to complete the Spiral Abyss. In other MMOs, randomly rolling for loot as a part of completing raids or dungeons is often a primary aspect of the game. But in other MMOs, you have the ability to trade items of other people or buy and sell them in an in-game marketplace. For example, if you get a really good weapon for Black Mage, but you're playing Astrologian, if you have a friend that happens to be playing Black Mage, you can just give him the weapon. If you're really unlucky, you can just go on the game's marketplace and sell your items for the ones you need. But if I'm trying to build Noelle in Genshin and my friend rolls a really good geo damage goblet and he doesn't have any geo characters, he can't just give that goblet to me. None of this is to even mention the most bizarre aspect of this, which is that Genshin locks artifact progression behind their terrible and outdated stamina system, which gates basically any gathering of resources related to character progression. It's not enough that running domains is mind-numbingly boring and that the artifact system is clearly designed of 10 different layers of RNG nonsense to artificially restrict the rate at which players can build and progress their teams. They also decided it was necessary to lock it behind a stamina system. The only reason Genshin Impact is able to get away against a predatory monetization scheme, where the game's best characters and weapons are locked behind a gacha system with hilariously low rates, and having an artifact system that is designed to be as annoying as humanly possible, is because there is not any content in this game that requires you to have the strong 5-star characters and min-maxed artifacts. Let's be clear, Genshin Impact is pay to win. The 5-star characters are all objectively better than any of the 4-star or free options. The best characters in this game, namely Hu Tao and Ganyu for DPS and Zhongli for support, are all locked behind the limited gacha. All the free characters in the game that you're given, Lisa, Kaya, Amber, and the Traveler, are some of the weakest characters in the entire game, which pushes you towards rolling on the gacha to get stronger characters. Not to mention the constellation system, which awards you upgrades for your characters for rolling them multiple times on the gacha. Ironically, the free-to-play characters are the hardest to get constellations for because they only drop from the standard banner and are never rated up on the event banners, so counterintuitively, they are actually the most expensive characters to max out. There's also the weapon system. The game deliberately locks all of its best weapons behind some form of payment, whether it be the weapon gacha banner, which no free-to-play players probably ever use, the battle pass, or the star glitter shop. In most other games, this would probably be seen as incredibly predatory, but Genshin is able to massage their terrible game design decisions behind cute anime waifus and husbandos, and people just eat it up, probably because 1, there is no real competitive multiplayer component, and more importantly, none of the content available requires you to have any of this. This crap is only here for mega whales or waifu evangelists who feel like they really need to C6 and max out their waifu of choice. It is very possible to complete 412 with the Spiral Abyss being a free-to-play player because ultimately, the artifact system is the primary determinant of power. But therein lies the problem. By structuring their game like this, they have completely shot themselves in the foot when it comes to creating challenging and interesting endgame content. The last 3 patches have all been full of filler content as everyone waits for Inazuma. The only real reason to play Genshin is as a waifu collecting game. If you're someone who's drawn to the exploration or combat aspects of the game, there's frankly not enough content for you. MiHoYo fundamentally cannot create difficult endgame content with decent rewards without risking alienating large parts of their player base. Most of the game's most difficult content is basically just a DPS stat check of your character's equipment. Compare this to a game like Monster Hunter, which also has a degree of randomness and monster drops that power up your gear, but ultimately the game requires the player to have a degree of game knowledge and skill in execution in order to succeed. Genshin cannot heavily require player execution as a facet of difficulty because a substantial part of the player base plays on mobile and would simply not have the ability to make complicated maneuvers. They also cannot increase the DPS check element too high either because they have structured their game where paying money directly increases your power level. At present, nobody cares that it can cost literally $2,000 to C6 a 5-star because that marginal boost in power literally does not matter. People tolerate the horrid artifact system because you don't need to waste hundreds of hours of your life min-maxing your artifacts because none of the content requires it. If miHoYo were to ever create content that did in fact require you to do either of these things, people would understandably be quite pissed at what seems like an openly greedy maneuver to punish people who didn't spend money to get the best characters and equipment. To be clear, I'm not saying that you can't enjoy Genshin Impact. I still play the game despite my complaints, but ultimately you need to accept that this game can never really become more than a casual anime waifu collecting game because of its failures of design, which is really a shame because the game has so much potential. The game would never be a Breath of the Wild level contained adventure game because it's also trying to be a live service anime gacha game. The game can also never succeed as a dungeon or boss oriented action combat MMO because of how the game's monetization system is directly tied to the player's power level. In essence, the game's most broken elements, the gacha system and the artifact system, are only allowed to exist precisely because the MMO and adventure aspects of this game are not meaningfully challenging. miHoYo's only real solution to keep players playing long term is to consistently churn out these filler events where you play hide or seek or something because they don't have any other options. Creating new regions like Inazuma is no doubt time consuming and expensive, and fixing the game's endgame by creating challenging, raid-esque, or dungeon experiences would alienate players who don't want to waste their life min-maxing in Genshin Impact. Quite frankly, I think if you stripped away the cute anime characters, this game would rightfully be panned for its predatory and hostile monetization and game design choices. Cynically, one can say that miHoYo knows precisely what they're doing, and have deliberately designed their game full of random elements to hook people into a Skinner box that uses the fear of missing the limited anime waifu in order to milk money out of players. If you want to spend hundreds of dollars getting the cute anime waifu of your dreams, that's fine. But I think people need to be aware of miHoYo's failure in creating a game with a coherent design philosophy, and seriously consider whether it's worth spending this kind of money on a game that is frankly not very interesting to play after a certain point.